Hello, this is Lewis from Cervion. Welcome to today's training session. Our topic for the day is standard table service order entry. We are going to learn how to log in, open a table, add items, send tickets to the kitchen, and close the table. Let's get started. First, I'm going to log in using my PIN. At the top of the screen, you will see the different sections that are available to you. We are going to work with the dining room section. Note that if you have multiple floor plans, they will also show up here. Let's open table 106. I'm going to tap on table 106. You may or may not be prompted to enter a guest count. This is customizable in your system. This system is set up to prompt to add a guest count. I'm going to say that there's two people on the table. So now we're going to navigate through the menu up top. You can see that I can slide back and forth to select the proper menu and category access. So that's what I'm doing right there. We're going to do a simple order and start with the lunch menu, appetizers, and we'll choose loaded nachos. So appetizers, loaded nachos. We are now going to go into the lunch sandwiches screen and we're going to choose the steak sandwich. You will see here that I cannot proceed until I choose a meat temperature. This is considered a forced modifier. I'm going to select medium rare. The second customer would like to order the chicken sandwich with no lettuce. I'm going to select the chicken sandwich, and then on the on-screen check to the left, I'm going to tap the chicken sandwich, and I'm going to tap the no lettuce modifier. Now that that's complete, I'm going to hit the done button. To send this order to the kitchen, you have three options on the bottom right. The first option that you'll see on the left here is the hold and send feature. This is used when you would like to hold some or all items for a later time. We will discuss that in a moment. Send and stay, the second one in the middle, is used if you have a large order and want to send a portion of the order while you are still entering the items. An example of this is if you had a party of 10 and they all ordered drinks from the bar, appetizers, and entrees, the server can enter the drinks from the bar, then tap send and stay. It will stay on the screen. And then from there, they could finish ordering the rest of the order or complete the order and then choose send and exit. The send and exit button is the last button that you'll see, and this is probably the button that's used most often. This button will send anything that has not been sent to a remote kitchen printer or bar printer or any remote printer and exit out of the ticket. We're going to select this now. So I'm going to select send and exit. Depending on how your system is set up, it'll either exit completely out back to the login screen, or it'll exit back to the order screen. So before we complete today's section, let's go over what the hold and send feature does. So this time I'm going to open up table 105. Again, there's two people at the table. We're going to order from the lunch menu again. So lunch menu, appetizers. I'm going to choose the loaded nachos. And then we're going to go in and we're going to go to the sandwiches menu again. So sandwiches. This time we'll just select chicken sandwich and the steak sandwich, medium rare. Now what we want to do is we want to send the nachos into the kitchen, and then 5 minutes from now we would like the entrees to get sent into the kitchen. So the server is actually coursing out or timing this out for us. So I'm going to select hold and send. You will see a pop-up box come up. In this case, all we want to do is select the loaded nachos, and then we're going to hit send. You can either choose a specified date and time or an interval from now. We want to send this ticket in 5 minutes, so I will enter in the interval from now the number 5, and I would hit confirm. Before I hit confirm, the date and time is there so that if you wanted to send this in at 7 o'clock tonight, or if you wanted to send this in tomorrow, you also have the option to do that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hit confirm, and now you will see that the ticket is blue to let you know that there are held items on the ticket. After the 5 minute timer, the ticket will send automatically to the kitchen or to anywhere where the items are assigned to a remote printer, and the table will turn orange. You can reference the table statuses down here at the bottom. As always, if you have any questions, please contact our help desk. Thanks for joining this session.